Good morning, this is Dylan, broadcasting live from CeBIT 2012, GSM Exchange Trade Zone. I'm here in our media zone with Mr. Sandeep Dhanuka from company Century Export Limited from Hong Kong. How are you, Mr. Sandeep?
Fine, thank you.
How do you find CeBIT? You only arrived. You seem busy.
It's nice. I think this year is going to be very good. The crowd looks something new, better than past 2 years. And hope it turns out good for everyone.
We were trying to do that, you know, that's why we're creating the trade zone, to make sure everybody's busy and happy.
Everybody looks happy here, I can tell you this. Yeah.
That's a good start. Tell us a bit more about your company. I know you're in business for a long time. We know each other for a long time, but tell us how it all started.
Basically, we started Century Exports Limited in about 2000, year 2000, and the same year we entered mobile phone business. We have seen a lot of up and down both in mobile phone business. A lot of brands came in and went out. But right now we see Samsung, Apple, Nokia competing too a lot. But we see good future with Samsung and BlackBerry and Apple right now.
So these are the strongest brands. So you've been in business for so long. What do you think is different now than it used to be? What do you think? The smartphone explosion, the tablets, the low end disappears in exchange, as opposed to the smartphone. What do you think is happening?
I would mention this. Dylan, low end is never going to disappear. I can be very sure about this. There's always a market for low-end. So, okay, smartphone definitely will become a must for life, because as you see, phones are no longer just phones. They are personal computers. But definitely there will be more demand for smartphones, but definitely the low-end phones will also have their mark.
What if the low-end phones is actually a smartphone which is very affordable? Do you see that happening?
Not very soon. Not very soon.
What about the second tier branded, you know, phones like that coming from China? Do you think they're going to make it big anytime soon? The likes of ZTE, Huawei, they're going very strong. Can you see them upsetting the big brands?
I like to just mention, I do a lot of Chinese mobile as well.
That's what I'm asking you.
Yeah, thank you. One of a very good brand called G5. It's a major brand from China, dominating Indian market. In year 2009, it was number two brand after Nokia in India.
That's huge.
Yeah, they sold good quantities in India. They're dominating India market. And when I see the markets like the third world countries, emerging countries, but like India, Pakistan, South Africa, this all they have a market. If you must be aware right now, if you're talking about smartphones at the low end, there are few brands in China which have come out with a very cheap price with a smartphone. Those will definitely take over. I see that they are taking over. They have a life.
And emerging markets, can you see them making it into the established markets, or that's a long way off still?
Established market I don't see right now. The reason being because, not because of the product. For the established market, there are a lot
the
of...
The mindset.
It's not only the mindset. You see, there are a lot of red tapes, a lot of certificate issues. And of course, mindset is one of the major things. If I want in Europe to sell an Asian product as a trader, because we are here in GSM Exchange as a trader platform, right? And you know very well, if an Asian product needs to be sold in Euro, it's a bit tough than the Euro product. They have a different mindset altogether.
That's interesting. And having said all this, and I appreciate your perspective on the business as well, would you think anything is going to... What I'm trying to say, do you see any big obstacles in front of the mobile phone business, the market that's going to happen next year? Do you see any major changes shaping up, or it's going to be just general trading, loads of smartphone, tablets? Can you see anything big coming up?
Definitely big in a good way, I would say this. Not obstacle. I would take it in a better way. We are having a lot of products. Smartphones are coming up, new brands are coming up, new products are coming. So we see an explosion of more demand. Rather than obstacle, I would say I see it in a good way.
Okay, you see growth and you see future for the whole industry. That's brilliant. Now, I know that you know GSM Exchange for a long time, really, really long time actually.
The day it was formed, basically, I can say this, you know.
So we've grown together. So it will be very valuable actually for us to have your feedback, your take on what's the feature, the service on GSM Exchange that benefits you the most as a trader, as a business person?
I would say GSM Exchange give me a lot of exposure in the market. Maybe I'm sitting in one end of the world, in a different time zone. at night Hong Kong, 3 o'clock, I can't keep calling looking for customers who want this product. I just post my product, it gets shot out to the people looking or they come back to me. Okay, they are ups and good and bad about everything, but I see in the good way. I want to look at the good side, you know. I get customers approach to me, I get references. If I have any problem, I call Dylan. Dylan, how do you find this guy? Dylan gives me a reference, he's a good guy. So
I don't know.
No, it's just a good thing about it, you know. Okay. I see a good future with
it. That's the main thing. Okay, I really appreciate your good words. We'll try to improve, because you always have to improve to keep you happy. I know that's how it should be. We shouldn't be complacent. I would like to thank you for the good words. Thank you for having us. Thank you for being with us in the Trade Zone.
A little bit cheaper. Try to
sorry, I didn't hear this one now. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. This was Sandeep, and thank you very much, Dylan, GSM Exchange Trade Zone CeBIT 2012.